Thank you. We'll be right back. to East Atlanta. Oh, but my heart is in Havana. God is in Havana.
Jumbo, 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 jum And welcome. Good evening. And welcome to the 2020 Conard High School commencement ceremonies. My name is Lindsay Tringali, and I am an assistant principal at Conard High School. I am honored to be a part of the Conard community and to be a part of this truly special ceremony to recognize the class of 2020 for earning their well-deserved diplomas. In a moment, we will hear our national anthem, sung by our senior choir members. Out of respect for social distancing, please do not feel the need to leave your cars, but I would ask anyone not in a vehicle to stand, if able. Please tune to 94.5 FM so that you can enjoy our national anthem, sung by Conard's senior choir members.
Say.
Those who have been standing may now be seated. Please join me again in welcoming our senior choir members as we listen to their performance of the Conard Alma Mater. Thank you, choir students, and Mr. Urich, for your efforts in putting this music together so that we can enjoy it tonight. Dr. Lorna Thomas Farkerson and members of the Board of Education, Superintendent Mr. Tom Moore and members of the executive team, Director of Human Resources Mr. Rick Ledwith, and members of the Farmington Police Department, honored guests, parents, families, and friends. On behalf of the faculty, staff, and administration of Conard High School, it is my pleasure to officially welcome you to this evening's commencement ceremony at the Farmington Polo Club, where we will celebrate and honor the remarkable class of 2020. We thank you in advance for observing the guidelines set forth by the Farmington Valley Health District and the Farmington Police Department. As a reminder, please remain in your vehicles during the program. At the appropriate time, after all names are recited, Principal Duarte will signal to our graduates to exit on the passenger side and make their way to the front of their car, where they will move their tassels from right to left to signify that they have graduated. In the meantime, we ask that everyone remain in their vehicle. Premier Photography is present this evening and will be taking pictures throughout the evening. Pictures should be posted tomorrow after 12 for you to peruse and order if you would like. Their ordering information is on the back of the program. We also request that you continue to respect the polo grounds and their property and refrain from throwing anything, including confetti or any other objects, out of your vehicle. In the event of a significant need, an emergency arises, please turn your emergency hazards on and signal one of the adults in your row sitting in the chairs. In a serious emergency, please dial 911 while also flashing your hazards. We are incredibly thankful to be here this evening, and thank you to our first responders and healthcare workers for making this possible and keeping us safe. Tonight's celebration is due to the work, dedication, and commitment from many members and organizations in our community. While we have all worked hard to clear paths for our students throughout their West Hartford Public Schools experience, this year has presented many challenges, and tonight is no exception. The fact that we are here at this moment is a credit to the outstanding reputation, grit, and character of the class of 2020. As a result, there has been an outpouring of support offered by local and regional agencies and organizations. All of these efforts are to ensure that you, the class of 2020, are honored tonight and enjoy the commencement ceremony you have earned. While I describe these efforts, I would ask that you hold your applause and honks until all groups and people are mentioned. First and foremost, I'd like to thank Mr. Scott Porter, who put together the musical selection and pictures you heard and watched for the first hour prior to these festivities. I know this was not initially in the plan, but we thank you for your willingness to always go above and beyond. Mr. Porter, you were retired for, I think, less than a day, and then we put you right back to work. So thank you. Holly Ruiz, thank you for your work in organizing and creating the Class of 2020's yearbook. We are also grateful to the Polo Grounds for hosting this event and to Carlos Landro and his team for the technical support. It's been amazing. It's been an amazing professional experience working alongside you and your team. Thank you to the main office staff and custodial staff who have worked tirelessly on the logistics, both large and small. Conard faculty and staff, thank you for being here tonight to support the graduating class. Eric Dempsey, West Hartford Public Schools Director of Security and Safety, and his staff have been a part of all of the celebrations during quarantine for our students. Thank you for your time and effort in planning and ensuring our safety during the parades and this evening. Another special thank you to Ann McKernan, West Hartford Public Schools Director of Secondary Education. She is amazing. Somehow she has managed to not only plan for and attend the parades and graduations, but also to troubleshoot and think about the details so that the students on both sides of town have events to truly remember as they reach this milestone. Her dedication to our schools and our students is unmatched. Mrs. Karen Contorno and Nicole Nyland, our senior class advisors, also deserve a thank you for the work they have done with this class in terms of fundraising and event planning. I would also like to thank our mayor, Sherry Cantor, and the town council. Thank you for all of your support in our schools that help our students succeed. Thank you to Premier Photo for ensuring that every graduating senior had the opportunity to get their picture taken with their diploma, and for being here this evening. Thank you also to the West Hartford Community Television for covering this event. Thanks to them, it's currently being live streamed. Thank you to the Parent Volunteers and Safe Grad Planning Committee for all you do for our students, specifically this year, which required out-of-the-box thinking, planning, and implementing various ways to celebrate the graduating class. Lastly, parents, grandparents, and other family and friends of the graduating class, thank you for helping our students get to this point. Please join me in acknowledging all of these organizations and people. Thank you. Our first speaker this evening is Caitlin Gilson, the president of the graduating class. Please welcome her to the stage.
Good evening, family, friends, faculty, and fellow graduates. Welcome to the Class of 2020's commencement ceremony. Seniors, we made it. It has truly been one crazy year. And although this is not the kind of graduation we expected, or the senior year that we had envisioned, it is definitely a time we will always remember. It has been a long time coming, and at some points, we didn't even know if our graduation ceremony was going to happen. Hashtag social distancing. My name is Caitlin Gilson, and I am the senior class president. On behalf of the class of 2020, I would like to thank everyone who played a part in helping us all get here today. Our parents, family, friends, Central Office of Administration, members of the Board of Education, Conard's wonderful faculty, our principal, Mr. Duarte, and assistant principals, Mr. Fisk, Mr. Hines, and Ms. Tringali. Thank you for the guidance you have given us and the patience you have shown in teaching us things that we will take with us into a world of unknowns. I would also like to thank the PTO for providing lawn signs for the graduating seniors. And lastly, thank you to everyone who made our senior parade such an amazing event. I remember as a freshman being told that high school flies by, and thinking how crazy that was because 4 years can't go by that fast. Well, it sure did, because here we are 4 years later at graduation. High school is just one chapter in our lives, and we have so much ahead of us. I really believe that Conard, our middle and elementary schools, and the town of West Hartford have prepared us for the next chapter in our lives. Although this, by no means, has been a traditional year, and we missed out on a regular graduation, senior prom, safe grad, and many more experiences, I feel compelled to look back at everything we were able to have with a smile. All the football games, basketball games, and many more sporting events we were able to go to, all the sports and clubs we were able to participate in, all the art performances we put on, including band, choir, orchestra concerts, and school plays, the school trips we went on, all the hard work we put in, homecoming, junior prom, hanging out with friends, and of course, going to class every day. These events and our memories from the past 4 years, especially our senior year, are ones we will hold forever. The knowledge and the friends we have gained will last a lifetime. I wish you all endless opportunities, happiness, and success. Now that we are all experts on remote learning and unexpected changes, we are even more prepared for the world ahead. So congratulations to all of my classmates on finishing high school in such an unforgettable year. Here comes Conard High School's graduating class of 2020. We did it. Mr. Duarte has typically spoken after the senior class president. However, this year, he wanted to give this honor to Superintendent Moore because it is a special year as his daughter is also graduating. So at this time, I would like to introduce Superintendent Tom Moore. Thank you.
Good evening, class of 2020. It's been a long time to get here from when you started in school up to what's been the longest 3 months of many of our lives. I feel so fortunate to be here, maybe than ever before, and I speak with a little bit of experience as this is my 25th Conard graduation. I've spoken at graduations as a history teacher, coach, Conard principal, assistant superintendent, superintendent, and now tonight, for the second time, I have the unique honor of speaking as a dad, along with all those other things, because our experience has become a part of who we are. Your time at Conard has defined you up till now, but what comes in the future, that'll be up to you. I've spent a lot of time thinking about what we've lost over the past few months, and I've also spent time realizing some of the things we've gained, and it comes to time. Instead of always having somewhere to be, someone to meet, there's been a little more time to kill, and I've taken to going on these long walks through town and just feeling time slow down a little bit. Sometimes the time has gone exceptionally slow over the past 3 months, we all know. But time's led me to think about the Princeton Seminary experiment in the 1970s. Social psychologists John Darley and Dan Batson engaged in this. What they did is they took Princeton Theological Seminarians, so people studying to be priests at Princeton. Pretty good people, you would think. And they told them all They were going to give a sermon on the other side of campus. Half of them were assigned to give a sermon about the Good Samaritan, the story where people that were exceptionally holy had left, passed by somebody that was suffering, and it was a regular person that gave them aid and comfort. One group of seminarians was told, "You're running late. Everybody's ready for you. They're waiting." Another group was told, "You're on time. They're ready. Head on over." The third group was told, "You've got time, but you might as well head over now." On their way over, they walked by a victim of something in an alley, clearly suffering. Of the people that were told they'd be early, 63% of them stopped to give aid and comfort. Of the people that were told they were on time, 45% of the seminarians stopped to give aid and comfort. Of those that were told they were late and they better get there, only 10% stopped to comfort somebody in need. The lesson from this that's been accepted over the past 50 years, as I was taught this years ago, is that situations drive our actions, not our intrinsic qualities. That these were good people, but because the situation was making them rush, that's why they didn't stop to help. And it didn't matter. Even those that were giving a sermon about the Good Samaritan had no higher incidence of stopping. And everybody kind of accepts this theory that, well, only 10% of those in a hurry stopped. Which means 90% of us will just go along if we're in a rush. And we think about how much of our lives are rushed until these past 3 months. But I've got to think of it in a different way. 10% stopped. They were told they had to be somewhere, and they stopped because somebody needed them. That's our charge, not to be one of the 90, to be special. The lessons of all the faculty that were there, of people waving you through, of parents calling me over and over, telling me you deserve graduation, I get it. It's because you're special. But our specialness is not defined by the qualities we think we have. It's defined by what we do when someone needs us. And you've got a whole lifetime to prove that you're special. So I'm a dad here tonight, and about 18 and a half years ago, when I got home on a day that was unlike any other day, my wife said to me, "We're going to have another baby." It was September 11th, 2001. And I don't know how many of you were in the womb at the time of September 11th, or how many of you were born soon after. But I can tell you as a dad, you've always been special because you came from a time much like now where there was doubt. There was fear. There was insecurity. People didn't know what it meant to be an American. We did come together, but a lot of people said, "What kind of a world am I bringing my child into?" And I know somebody today is finding out they're going to have a baby and they're wondering those same questions. But my daughter and all of you, to those that love you, have always represented special. From a time when we were low, 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 to a night tonight when we're coming out of a dark period, hopefully, but we can come together to celebrate. You've been special. Don't be one of those people that just curses the darkness. Be candles Be light. Be the 10% that lives up to your qualities. Be who we know you are because you've been that for us for 18 years. I'm so fortunate to work in this community. I'm so fortunate to have spent my career at Conard. And I'm very fortunate to be Jack and Fallon's dad. And just like them, I know all of you that are kids that are sitting in cars with your parents. It's not what you pictured, but it's special because we're together. Be it parents, guardians, really all that matters is who's with you that loves you. And you should know, looking at this group here and the teachers that came as you came by, you are deeply loved. We have faith in you. We believe in you. And we know that you will be special. Good luck, class of 2020. Welcome a true friend to the stage and somebody who does stand up for our kids and always demands more. And I say that we are fortunate to have her on our Board of Education, our Vice Chair, Ms. Lorna Thomas-Farquharson.
Hello, and greetings to our Conard High School graduating class of 2020. On behalf of my fellow Board of Education colleagues, Deb Holloon, Mark Zazanowitz, Amanda Aronson, Ari Steinberg, and Liz Wilcox, as well as recently former colleagues, Sean Payson and Rob Levine, we say congratulations, and we are very proud of your accomplishments. Today marks a day in your academic journey where all the years you've put into receiving, studying, and learning has culminated into today's special occasion, recognizing all that you have accomplished. And what have you accomplished? Well, in your hands, you will hold, or you are already holding, tangible evidence, recognizing and crediting all that you've accomplished by completing your high school experience within the West Hartford public school system at Conard High School. Something tangible in your hand. Tangible in your hand, tangible in your hand. Well, but we cannot forget, nor should we overlook something else you've accomplished. And this is something not held in your hand, but held in an even more powerful place, your mind. Knowing that in spite of living through a public health crisis, living through a pandemic that impacted every community, near and far, including our very own, a pandemic that drastically altered lives, a pandemic that took lives, a pandemic that impacted every region of this country, every continent overseas, a pandemic known as COVID-19. You're living through a pandemic. However, your accomplishment is much greater than that. You are not defined by a pandemic. In spite of living through a moment in history, a moment in her story, a moment in our story, a moment that has never been seen before in modern times, you persevered and you made it through. You had a dream to graduate from high school. You turned that dream into a goal. You put in the work to accomplish that goal. It was not just handed to you. Again, in your hands, you have the paper. But your diploma represents so much more. As Shauna Rhimes once said, dreams are lovely, but they are just dreams. Fleeting, ephemeral, pretty. But dreams do not come true just because you dream them. It's hard work that makes things happen. It's hard work that creates change. Today marks a day when your hard work has paid off. You may unequivocally, without challenge, claim that you kept your eyes on the prize. You did not give up. You seized the opportunity to complete this journey no matter what. Seized the opportunity. Opportunity, opportunity. What is an opportunity? An opportunity is defined as a set of circumstances that makes it possible to do something. Winston Churchill once said, "A pessimist sees the difficulty in every opportunity. An optimist sees the opportunity in every difficulty." In spite of all of the challenges you faced in the present and possibly from the past, in spite of all of the difficulties you've experienced, clearly something inside of you recognized this as an opportunity to persevere and see your journey through to this day. Well, today we are here to celebrate you. Most people have their go-to song that helps to get them motivated for a special occasion, helps to get them pumped up. I know you all are in your cars, but just give me a honk if you have a go-to song that you listen to. No? All right. Here we go. I know some may have Rocky's Eye on the Prize or Eye on the Tiger or Queen's We Will Rock You or maybe DJ Khaled, All I Do Is Win. Well, I have my go-to song that I like to listen to when I'm getting ready maybe to go for a long jog up a big hill or getting ready for a special occasion, and that's Eminem, his song Lose Yourself. You better lose yourself in the moment. You want it. You better lose yourself in the moment. You want it. You know it. You better never let it go. You only get one shot. Do not miss your chance to blow, because opportunity comes once in a lifetime. Opportunity. Opportunity, opportunity. Opportunity. You had an opportunity. Not just to attend high school, but to finish high school. You took advantage of that opportunity. You received, you studied, and you learned. And now you are a high school graduate. However, the opportunities to receive, to study and learn do not end here. Whether your next step from here is to attend college or university, enter the workforce, or join the armed forces, opportunities to continue learning are endless. For life is the ultimate classroom. You will find some lessons you learned earlier on in your academic career reappear at different times in your life. Subjects you may have thought had little relevance in everyday life. Well, you realize in more ways than one, their principles are timeless. Remember that math class learning about ratios and percentages? Well, before the pandemic, when dining out or ordering in was more readily accessible, try figuring out how to leave a tip for a waiter or waitress without knowing how to calculate percentages. Okay, well, we're in the midst of a pandemic. Try figuring out how to make hand sanitizer without understanding fractions, ratios, and percentages. Remember learning about the philosopher Aristotle? Remember learning he once said, "The whole is greater than the sum of its parts." In other words, things work better unified as one, versus being situated apart as individual pieces. The whole is greater than the sum of its parts. I want to pause here and rewind for a moment. Earlier, when recognizing all that you've accomplished during a pandemic, I referred to the pandemic as COVID-19. Now, one thing I try to do when I'm engaging with others, I try to keep it real. And keeping it real, that also means recognizing the past and present reality of how race-conscious our country is, and recognizing that we continue to live in a global pandemic called racism. Conard students, class of 2020, you are living during a time when there is an uprising of people, young and old, rich and poor, near and far, who are saying enough is enough. We as a society are depending on you. Our youth. Enough is enough. We as a society are depending on you, our youth, who've already proven to us how resilient and goal-driven you are, to help make our tomorrow better than today. Now, remember Aristotle, and remember how he said the whole is greater than the sum of its parts? That theory especially holds true now. In this great nation of ours called the United States of America, What makes this country great is that all of the people who help to build and sustain it. The only way we can claim greatness as a country is by recognizing and respecting all individuals from all walks of life, all backgrounds, all ethnicities, all races, including those who are black, because black lives matter. If we don't recognize and respect black lives, we are not whole as a country. If we are not whole as a country, we cannot claim greatness. The whole is greater than the sum of its parts. Now, some may say, well, I'd rather leave well enough alone. I'd rather not get involved. That's not how I think. I just want to keep to myself. Well, such silence can be deafening. And in the words of Dr. Martin Luther King Jr., in the end, we will remember not the words of our enemies, but the silence of our friends. What we are talking about does not just reflect this moment in time. We are talking about a movement forward towards something this country has yet truly and unconditionally experienced. As Audre Lorde once said, it is becoming always vigilant for the smallest opportunity to make a genuine change in established, outgrown responses. For instance, in learning to address each other's differences with respect. So, class of 2020, as you begin the next chapter in your life, always remember you have achieved something spectacular by making it to this point here today. You have shown that hard work and determination pay off in the long run. You have achieved your high school diploma, and you have earned your diploma while being part of a historic, of many historic events. You have accomplished so much by being a part of history. Wow! I dare to see what you can accomplish by making history. This is your moment. This is your opportunity. Claim it. It is my honor to introduce our next speaker, Ramona Pochaus-Peretti, and she has been voted by this year's class to be their speaker. She has been teaching for the past 17 years as an English teacher. 14 of those have been here at Conard High School. Please welcome her.
I need a picture of this. Good evening, and welcome graduates of Conard High School class of 2020. Their families, friends, both here with us and at home taking part in this unique evening. Welcome members of the Board of Education, our leadership team, and our remarkable faculty and staff, and all those who have helped this come together. With this class, I also want to acknowledge and honor those of you, honor those you love, who are not with you today. They left remarkable legacies in the world in each of you. I could not be prouder or more humble to be here. Whether I knew you all 4 years, or you stopped by my classroom to sit on my couch, I need you to know you made my world better. You made me better. I have the words, "The future of the world is in this classroom," stenciled on the wall in room 271. And they have never been more fitting. It is a beautiful night for the chapter of your story where you graduate from high school. This may not look the way you expected, and things have certainly gone off track, but never underestimate a beautiful sunset. It is an exquisite setting for this part of your story, and your story has not been an easy one. In the next chapter of your story, it will not be difficult to find people with whom your story intersects. Your experiences with distance learning and isolation, the losses suffered, and the struggles endured will thread across many narratives. Additionally, a monumental drive to rise up in the midst of a pandemic and stand beside one another for what you know to be right as it unfolds before your eyes. Your story is a remarkable one. I love stories. I believe in their power. The writings of women like Alice Walker and Chimamanda Ngozi Adichie deepened my belief regarding the importance of discovering our own stories and listening to the stories of others. Both black women, both feminists. Alice Walker taught me that our identity and our story was written long before we ever entered the narrative. Our stories and histories are gardens which were planted by those who came before us. Some gardens have been carefully tended because their keepers had the privilege of time and tools and land. Others have been hidden away or difficult to find. They were forgotten or someone tried to destroy them. Yet they still grew, even under the most harsh of conditions. Chimamanda Ngozi Adichie reminded me, first, always make sure people pronounce your name properly. Don't let them change it for you. Chimamanda Ngozi Adichie reminded me, stories matter. Many stories matter. A single story is not enough if we wish to break the singular narratives which across the globe have permeated our lives and learning for too long. Storytelling has been controlled by those who have historically seen themselves as greater than others. Power has been taken by determining when stories are told, by whom, as well as which narrative gets shared, and even how. All around you, in our community alone, are boundless stories just waiting to be heard and told. Yes, we are diverse, but the diversity of our school and our community is nothing more than data without the narratives. There is colossal power in those stories, your stories, but only if we are willing to make space and listen. I believe listening is the most vital skill we teach, and also the most difficult to master. I have an entire rubric for it, ask my kids. Investing in another person and quieting the voice in our own head to allow that story to be heard is hard. It requires sharing privilege and amplifying another voice, making it part of the narrative, even when you believe you already know the story. Perhaps this is the first time some of you have truly begun to see and acknowledge the singular narratives and historical frames by which this country has been shaped, which gives power to some and strips it from others. Taking power from a person, stripping them of their identity, is as simple as refusing to listen. When we neutralize the voices of those we consider other, or remove them and their experience, we are changing the landscape and the scope of history. It is time for the full story to be told, but it requires the ability to actively and willingly listen. Listening and hearing another person's story may be one of the most compassionate acts we can perform as human beings. Over the years, students have inspired me with the discoveries they made when uncovering their own stories, specifically those of women in their lives. Members of this class were particularly impactful and galvanized me to dive more deeply into my own story, my own garden. I have faith in all of you, so I'm going to ask you to actively listen and bear witness to part of my story. Some details I've known since I was young. Others came to light more recently. On April 29th, 1975, Saigon, Vietnam was in turmoil as North Vietnam was on the cusp of taking control of the city and American forces prepared for a frenzied departure. My mother, Thuyet Bac Thi Tran, was 19 years old, the same age as a lot of you, or pretty close. She lived in a small town outside of Saigon. Several family members, including her mother, my grandmother, Dung, had worked for the Americans, which meant they would be targets of the communist regime. Their aid to the Americans, along with paying some hefty fees, provided some of them with passage on fishing boats and cruise ships to escape. To her dismay, my grandmother was told she could take one of her six children. So she decided she would take the baby. Thuyet, her sister Mai, and their three very young brothers would be sent for after her mother had safely escaped. A week prior to April 29th, she departed and promised she would see them soon. But as soon as Saigon began to fall, Thuyet's grandmother grew worried. At the last minute, she told her and Mai to flee with their aunt, her husband, and two young children who were already on a fishing boat in the bay. Go now, she told them. The arrival of the regime would be devastating, but it would be particularly dangerous for girls and women, as so often is the case in war. For some reason, one of the things Thuyet remembers clearly is the yellow cotton blouse and pants she was wearing. They were light yellow, with tiny butterflies, and her grandmother had made them. She and Mai packed what they could carry, hurried to the bay, and waded into the warm water just as the sun was setting. They were among the last to climb on a small fishing boat, along with at least 100 other refugees. They were at sea for well over a month and survived on a case of sardines. All 100 of them survived on a case of sardines, and that is after their boat was taken away and they were given a smaller one. Cruise ships going by dumped their scraps overboard just beyond the reach of starving refugees. When water breached the sides of the boat, as it often did, Thuyet and Mai each slept on either side of their family members to keep them warm and dry. To this day, Thuyet will not eat sardines. She will never set foot on a cruise ship. And she still makes sure everyone she loves and sometimes people she barely knows are warm and dry and fed. When my mother went searching to reunite with her mother, she learned she had arrived on the ship, but had immediately gotten off. She could not leave her children. And since the buses were no longer available, she walked all the way back to her village. It took her a week, carrying her youngest child. And when she arrived, she discovered her two daughters gone. My grandmother was sent to a work camp in 1975, she died in 1980. But before she died, she knew my mother had escaped. She saw pictures of me. She tended our garden by making unimaginable sacrifices. There is much more to my mother's story. Oftentimes, more darkness than light. But as Mr. Moore mentioned, find the light. Because when she shares her memories with me, one thing she recalls more vividly than anything else, just like the cotton blouse she wore, was the sunset on April 29th. She still says it was the most beautiful sunset she ever saw. As far as statistics go, I should not be standing in front of you right now. Truly, I am the biracial daughter of a woman who was a refugee. According to the indicators for success, I fall short. But my garden defies those indicators and that data. My mother once said, "Who would have ever thought I would have a daughter who would become an English teacher?" And in all fairness, how many Asian English teachers do you know? I used to question my path, but as I've grown to know my story, I've come to understand the garden the women in my family planted. The roots of tenacity and strength and compassion run deep in my garden, and it is up to me to become its caretaker and make sure their story is told. Conard class of 2020, I challenge each of you to become the caretaker of your garden. Start with your own story, because chances are you do not know all of it, maybe even little of it. Go discover your story, your garden, all of it. Tend to your garden. It may prove more difficult if people in your story are considered other. Immigrants, refugees, victims, survivors, they are known for tucking their story in a box and burying it. But don't give up. It's your story. Next. Better than that, there's another challenge. Next, I challenge you to seek out and hear the stories of others. Start here. Don't let mine be the only story you know of a refugee from Vietnam. Go in search of others. Speak with other people. Read books, whatever it takes to expand the breadth and depth of the story. And don't stop with Vietnamese refugees. Learn the stories of Somalian and Syrian refugees. Start right here in West Hartford. Let our diversity truly become our vibranium. Don't stop with the story of one black woman. Listen to the narratives of many black women, many black men, Muslims living in poverty, living with depression, all of them, many stories of all. Find the stories of people whose lives are different than yours, people who look and sound and work and eat and dance and dress and worship in ways unfamiliar to you, ways you may not understand. And don't stop at one. Then use whatever privilege you have. And you went to Conard, so no matter where you came from, you have some because you went here. Make space for those stories and lift them up. Privilege in and of itself is not a bad thing if you are willing to share it and use it to help others. Given everything with which we are grappling, the needs of our communities, our nation, the world, and those who are most at risk, stories are more important than ever. So take a deep breath and go out and tell your stories. Step back, open your heart and mind, and listen to the stories of others. Then demand a new one be written. The full story, your stories. Know that we will be here waiting to hear them. The future of the world is in front of me, and it's going to be one heck of a story. I love this class dearly. Over the past few weeks, seniors in the choir program at Conard were invited to record audio and video recordings of themselves performing "Don't Stop Believing." I may get up and dance, you know I will. For this ceremony, this piece was a student suggestion based on the need of all seniors to remember, "Don't Stop Believing." Sit back and enjoy the song being sung by the members of the senior choir.
Good evening, friends, family. Good evening, friends, family, and our amazing faculty. My name is Will McDonald, and I speak on behalf of the class of 2020. Graduates, as I stand here before you, I speak to you as your peer, and I understand the pain
each of us is experiencing. All around us are grim reminders of what could have been our senior spring. We have forever lost the opportunity of creating some of life's most memorable moments. We have lost the ability to attend prom, to skip school together as a class, to implement our senior prank of egging Mr. Hines' Jaguar, and most importantly, to have a normal graduation. Yet, we have overcome these obstacles and many more and arrived here at our graduation. For that, let's honk our horns. We have forgone these memories and experiences, but gained something many of us may deem as even more important, to become a part of history. Years from now, our children will come home from school to ask us about how we were changed and affected by this ongoing pandemic. They will call for us to help them write their paper on the George Floyd protests. They will ask us if we were scared of school shootings when they learn of the Parkland massacre and the ensuing nationwide protests. They may even wonder what life was like before the murder hornets attacked. We have already secured our place in the history of this nation and the history of the world. The only question that remains is, what's next? The late Kobe Bryant once said, "It's just a matter of the pieces that you have around you and what you can do to elevate everybody else." As we emerge from this community and say goodbye to our lifelong friends, we each depart on our own unique path. We are graduating into a divided country filled with civil unrest, economic uncertainty, and a pandemic with no clear end in sight. Without a doubt, the world is changing. Yet, we must not lose our individuality in order to change with it. Each of us have come from different backgrounds that have aided us in forming our unique perspectives. Many of us are immigrants or the children of immigrants. We all have differing political views. We all have separate interests. Yet, we are all preparing to enter our own life journeys. Over the past 4 years, we have been given the freedom to discover ourselves and to dive into what truly makes each of us original. Yet, despite our differences, each of us have been faced with struggles, and each of us have claimed victory. We have overcome our personal obstacles, whether they be academic, social, economic, or in any number of other areas. We must take what we have learned over these 4 years and apply our knowledge to whatever lies ahead. Nothing is certain, except that our futures are filled with uncertainty, anxiety, and an innumerable amount of questions. Nevertheless, the one thing we will always have is our inflexible desire to persevere. Those of you who feel as if they are not heard, don't be scared to shout louder. Those of you who feel isolated, you are not alone. Those of you who are terrified of change, you will find the strength. And lastly, those of you who feel insignificant, we can change the world. Together, we will drive out of these polo grounds and begin the next chapter of our lives. Take chances, try new things, but never, never forget the people who have been there for you. Thank you. Thank you. Next to the stage is another student speaker. Please give her a warm welcome. Sarah O'Donis.
Thank you, Will. Graduates, family members, and Conard faculty, good evening. Actually, it's a pretty great evening. We're graduating! Woo! Yeah! Woo! These past few weeks, I have been reflecting on my time at Conard. I have thought about physics this year, when our teacher issued out slinkies for a project. Unfortunately, someone in my lab group got wrapped up in that slinky. Have you ever tried to untangle a slinky? Well, that was our lab group's new task. This seemed pretty feasible, considering we were Conard seniors. That is where we were wrong. 10 minutes into untangling, the realization hit. This was going to be impossible. So, someone in my lab group impulsively decided to put the slinky in her backpack in order to untangle that home without the group. But then panic started to set in. We were seniors, and we didn't want to risk punishment for stealing and obstructing school property. So we went into the classroom and proceeded to untangle the slinky. In the end, our efforts were successful because we worked together. Conard, in a way, is like a giant slinky. It's a little overwhelming and it's easy to get tangled up, but that doesn't mean it's impossible to fix. Like my lab group, our school is about relationships that give us the support to untangle these kinks together. Strong relationships enable us to be better students and people. Each member of the Conard community shares their own life experience to enrich our environment. But it wasn't always like this. I remember freshman year when Mr. Duarte sat us down in the auditorium and challenged us to make Conard a better place. I rolled my eyes. I know many of you did too. I know sitting in that auditorium alongside 300 other freshmen, we all felt and looked so different from one another. It seemed ridiculous to think that we could come together to accomplish this challenge when we each found our own voice the most important. I don't need anyone's help untangling my slinkies. But 4 years later, I look back at my freshman self and think, Sarah, you were wrong. We have all needed each other to untangle these slinkies. So on the day of our graduation, we ask, did we do it? Did we keep Mr. Duarte's promise? Well, Conard has outperformed extensively in sports, academia, music, and arts affairs, winning awards and competitions left and right. But that is not what Mr. Duarte meant when he said make Conard a better place. A better place is one where everyone's experiences are valued. We, as students, are empathetic towards each other and have a deep care and concern for our peers and community that goes far beyond the classroom. And it is the reason why, when our slinky became tangled from COVID-19, we were able to rise above the tangles by working together. For some of us, that meant getting a job to support our family. For others, it meant taking time to focus on our mental health. And for some, it meant marching to the streets to advocate for greater justices in our communities. Regardless of the circumstance, this pandemic has widened and broadened our differences. And although the physical distance could have impacted us negatively, I have never felt closer to my Conard peers. We very well could have left each other to untangle this slinky alone. But no, that is not the promise that we made 4 years ago in that auditorium. Standing on stage, surrounded by the class of 2020, I know that we did not complete Mr. Duarte's challenge. We surpassed it. However, yeah, that's a good thing. We surpassed it! However, as we leave high school and enter the world, we recognize a need for change. The world we live in is full of injustices, and it is our responsibility to react and take action. At first glance, the tangles that we inherit seem impossible to fix, but that is not an excuse to give up and back down. As graduates of Conard High School, we have garnered the tactics, the knowledge, and the empathy to make positive change. Untangling will not be easy. Many of our peers have already begun the difficult process of recognizing and combating these injustices. It is now time for us all. We are ready. We are prepared. We will untangle. The class of 2020 looked adversity in the face and said, not me, not today, and not ever. We're the class that untangled the slinky. But we couldn't have done this alone. Thank you to the custodians, cafeteria staff, security guards, and nurses. Thank you to our administrators. Thank you to all the teachers that we have had over the last 4 years who have challenged us to think not only for ourselves, but for others. Thank you to our wonderful parents who, for the past few months, have unwillingly turned into our classmates. But most importantly, thank you to the class of 2020 for changing how I view the world and showing me the importance of working together. So, as we enter the next chapter of our lives, I remind us all that it is imperative to seek out tangled slinkies, and rather than be ignorant and silent to them, we must untangle them together as the class of 2020. Thank you. Mr. Duarte, it is now your turn to speak to the amazing class of 2020. Please refrain from slinky metaphors, as I've already used that technique.
Welcome, parents, grandparents, family, friends, and distinguished guests, to Conard High School's 63rd commencement ceremony. I would like to thank you for joining us this evening and for providing the love, support, and guidance that has helped foster the success of all of our students over the years. I would also like to thank the entire West Hartford community for your support of our amazing students. It was never more evident than during our car parade. And I have to be honest, during the entire time, I felt like a proud father. So thank you, and know that these students deserve it. Conard Class of 2020, we are all here today to celebrate and honor you. Although I recognize that this may not be exactly how you envisioned your graduation, it does not change the amount of hard work, dedication, and perseverance that was required to get here. That being said, no one can achieve such an accomplishment without having a strong support group to lean on. So over the next few days, please take a few minutes to thank the various people in your life who have helped support you along the journey. John Wooden famously once said, "The character is what you do when no one is looking." Over the last few months, I have constantly been reminded of this saying, as I have heard from numerous people about the countless acts of kindness that you would do, not for recognition, but because it would help someone, or it was simply the right thing to do. Such as a student who stayed on their Google Meet when everyone else left, so that they could privately volunteer to go grocery shopping for their teacher, because they knew that she was in the at-risk group. Or watching your willingness to constantly fight for what you know is right and just. These are the types of character traits that you demonstrate regularly. And it is because of you that I have hope for us and for our future. Conard Class of 2020, please know that I'm extremely proud of all that you have accomplished during your time at Conard,
And yes, Sarah, you have more than met my expectations. It has been my honor to be your principal. You are truly an amazing class, and I will miss you and miss seeing you on your Google Meets. Now, let's face it. Over the past few months, nothing has been ordinary, including this graduation. So I thought I would continue with that theme, and rather than just say my entire speech, I thought I would leverage the ability to use technology today and end my speech with a movie, a special movie that I create out of love for you. I hope that you enjoy it.
How did we get here? You looked forward to this day from the moment you entered these hallways, greeted by the cheers and claps of our faculty. Today was supposed to be filled with laughter, warm embrace, and tears of happiness as we say our last goodbye. There were so many things we wanted to share with you. From seeing you smile on prom night, to cleaning your locker out for the last time on that final day of school. But you've now been dealt the kind of blow we have tried so hard to shelter you from during your time here at Conard. You have lost a lot over the last few months, but it will not define you. Although you credit us with your many accomplishments, the reality is that we simply help you discover yourselves, your strengths, and your possibilities. The truth is, you make us better educators, and that is what drives us to show up every day, committed to giving you our best.
Where are we off to next?
Your dress is on.
Hi!
The days spent in the classrooms may have felt long, but the years, they flew by. You freely gave your time and energy in hopes of improving and inspiring our global community. You recognized and celebrated the diversity within our school and society.
And like Ida B. Wells said, the way to right wrongs is to turn the light of truth upon them. Thank you.
You are the leaders of tomorrow, and we need you now more than ever. Today is for you. We can't wait to see the mark you leave on this world. Congratulations, class of 2020. You will always be part of our Chieftain family.
It's up! Simplicio 3!
Class of 2020, thank you for an incredible 4 years. I wish you good health and good luck with all your future endeavors. And remember, don't stop believing. Go Chieftains! Although we had the pleasure of handing out diplomas and taking a photo with each graduate last week, we want to take time tonight to recognize each of them publicly. At this time, we will listen to each graduate's name being read. Thank you to our school counselors, Greg Ferry, Dawn Hoblett, Adam Linker, Kristen Mangini, Karen Morrison, and Bob Segee for reading the names. And a special thanks to Marisa Berry for helping to create the slideshow. During the presentation, I will ask that you please refrain from honking your car horn until all student names have been read. This will give each student his or her special moment, as both the graduates and family of the graduates can hear them and hear their names being read. Thank you.
Jesley Abreu, Matthew Adam. Jennifer Ariana Agrita Vasquez. Hamad Ahmed. Yazan El Dumani. Yusuf Margani Alber. Samira Kadada Alexander. Alishba Ali. Lucinda Alisi. Christopher Joseph Allen Jr. Yazid Omer Almazari. Zachary David Anaya. George Constantine Andrews. Guillermo Alejandro Antipas. Abel Anthony. Benjamin Ian Arkey. Nolan Maxwell Acido. Jason Alberto Aviles. Jeray Cinque Barlow. Alexander Dean Barnard. Devin Lawler Barnum. Kate Ann Bell. Mason Gregory Belville. Leonid Georgievich Belliev. Alexis Daniel Benitez. Aya Benkua. Jackson Paul Berrettini. William Roland Berry. Hayden Thomas Bissonnette. Xavier Sebastian Blackwell Lipkind. Alexis Rickless Blinder. Malaysia Murray Blue. John Alexander Boney. Nathan Alexander Bones. Wagner Fragasi Boku. Patricia Fernand Bolton. Samantha Rose Bowen. Kate Mackenzie Boyd. Giovanna De Sousa Braga. John Patrick Brennan. Brian William Brewer. Silas Shane Bridges. Amelia Jane Brightley. Jason Joseph Bruzon. Brian Joseph Burke. Nathan Jose Caez. James Hewitt Calvert. Juwam Campos Alves. Guillerme Cardosa de Freitas. William James Carson. Josiah Gabriel Carter. Renee Belinda Chamberlain. Jonah Mato Chantavong. Darren Chen. Natalie Ann Chernish. Gabriel Elijah Cherie. McKenna Elise Healy Chevrier. Samuel Luis Chozik. Ariana Elizabeth Claudio. Benjamin William Cohen. Zachary Morris Cohen. Yadiel Angel Concepcion. Sophia Irene Concepcion. DeLauren Combs.
Brian DaCosta Pinto. John Clark Dalton. Justin Dam. Tan Dow. Cameron Davidson. Rachel Davis. Trudy Davis. Emmy Delaney. Matthew DeLutri. Sabella DeMayo. Nicole Denault. Krista DiStefano. Kate DiGiacomo. Jasmine DeGenti. Ella DiPippo. Sophonius Dyrus. Sean Dombrowski. Haroon Dridi. Fallon Driver. Eileen Droney. Aubrey Dulnuan. Matthew Durham. Carolyn Eddy. Geldon Farah. Ryan Farley.
Owen Fernandez.
Hannah Farolano. Kenya Ferreira. Isha Fitzgerald. Julian Flores. Karina Flores. Aiden Foley. Jade Frioli. Samantha Fragan. John Gabinelli. Jillian Gallagher. Carla Lorena Garcia. Helen Catherine Gard. Milani Garrett. Aria Gotam. Elizabeth Geisler. Robert Garrity. Sarah Garrity. Jonas Getachew. Khalil Framund.
Elizabeth Giles.
Caitlin Melissa Gilson. Samantha Giuliano. Isabella Glynn. Xavier Goggins. Charlie Goglia. Jonathan Golden. Justin Goldstein. Nalasia Gomes. Antonio Gordon. Sarah Grady. Kaishan Grant. Jacob Gregory. Ishe Griffith. Sean Guevara.
Tao V. Ha. Asli Abdullahi Hassan. Max Hassan. Maggie Heller. Gabriel Hernandez. Matthew Gordon Hill. Jonathan Ho. Johnny Wang. Madison Lin Huang. Thomas John Hosick. Liza Hoy Hood. Mateo Hunter. Jenna Utensky. Edlira Isufi. Gracie Cho Iverson. Chris John Jagdet. Mateo Jaramello. Mia Jaworski.
Imani Johnson.
Makai Johnson. Sarah Wyman Kelly. Brian Falvey Kenna. Carlos Kerrigan Mock. Rahul Kadka. Sophia Grace Kim. Taeyun Kim. Faiza Karen. Gavin Thomas Klett. Ashley Kobielka. Sarah Cole. Jenna Caroline Kopp. Sebastian Kruger. Jack William Cunley. Caroline Kumpa.
Emily Kyle.
Liana Lau. Brianna Lay. Samantha Olivia Lee. Alced Lemieux IV. Tyreek Lewinson. Harrison Hamilton Lewis. James Little. Cheyenne Lopez. Miriam Lopez Cruz.
Joniel Lopez.
Madison Lopel. Samuel Loudon. William McDonald. Hannah Christine Mack. Christopher Philip Maglio. Devin Thomas Mahoney. Michael Majewski. Carlos Maldonado Garcia. Gabriel Maldonado. David Martin Malugin.
Anthony Mancini.
Shaneza Mirage. Olivia Marcella. Tyler Marino. Joseph Market Maestre. Daniel Markham. Trey Martin. Jorge Martinez Diaz. Joshua Massey. Andrew Mazzato. Allie McKenna. Nicholas McEwen. Joshua Meehan. Max Mega. Vanessa Meikle. Zoe McKinney. Natalie Miller. Fumio Minoguchi. Isabella Macadlo. Yasmin Mohammed. Jibril Mohamedou. Rashim Montez Daniels. Connor Montgomery. Daniel Moniak.
Fallon Moore.
Alexander Morales.
Ty Joseph Morales.
DeMarco Morgan. Jonathan Morey. Lindsay Monahan. Anastasia Mozanski. Rihanna Muchka. Andrew Murillo. Jonathan Murphy. Sam Musto. Alexander Naidu. Syed Naqvi. Matthew Nemergut. Tajroy Newman. Helen Nguyen. Henry Nguyen. Hugh Huynh. Ivy Nguyen. Justin Nguyen. Lana Nguyen. Tanya Nguyen. Vina Nguyen. Wilkie Ni. Veronica Needman. Clotilda Noble. Frank Nobu. Aaliyah Norton. Hollis O'Connor. Catherine O'Leary. Michael Ocasso. Ava Odlum.
Mufira Nicole Ogontola.
Areafe Eunice Oluwashina. Kayla Oriola. Victor Ortiz Jr. Kalia Ortiz.
Severio Palaya. Katana Park. Brendan Parker. Elizabeth Parker. Bramdeep Parmar. Joshua Pachenik. Tatiana Ruby Palais. Julian Perez. Benjamin Petkaitis. Emma Carolina Pinckney. Brock Pizzo Ferrato. Zoe Pizzo Ferrato. Ray Plucharczyk. Anisha Pokrel. Mary Grace Policelli. Gervail Prempa. Brian Paleo. Hubing Quach. Kaylin Quach. Jojo Lung Rai. Carmen Marielle Ramirez Para. Damian Ramos. Corinne Rufino. Ucase Rout. Jasmine Rawls. Melanie Abigail Racinos Vargas. Jorgens Remy. Ashley Jasmine Requenis. Dylan Richards. Nathan Rinaldi. Juan Rivera Velasquez. Navaya Rivera. Renee Starr Rivera. Jarissa Rivera. Brian Rivera Royal. Nicholas Roberts. Ashanti Robinson. Abigail Rockstatchel. Sarah Elizabeth Rodanis. Zayamara Delmar Rodriguez. Samuel Rothfarb. Sage Elizabeth Rovero. John Roy. Brianna Alize Ruiz. Brittany Salas. Kevin Salazar. Kelly Sanachera. Robert Alexander Sarkeesian. Talia Catherine Sarkeesian. Florence Diavila Sasu. Colin Savage. Nina Sayarat. Lisa Scanlon. Nancy Scanlon. Alexandra Scheib. Allison Schneider. Madeline Schott.
Nicholas Segarra. Kaylee Semph.
Devin Shea.
Bryn Elise Sherry. Lisa Shrestha. Arson Stefan. Isabella Simoes. Peter James Simplicio. Catherine Simpson. Gurjot Singh. Karanveer Singh. Rajveer Singh. Owen Smith. Lorenzo Loomer Sofarelli. Dianix Solar. Rachel Sun. Jonathan Kyle Sorgio. Quinn James Spada. Ethan Angelo Speranza. James Standish. Tyler Staron. Nicole Sutliff. Emma Elizabeth Tapia. Abriana Teodoro. Amy Then. Jason Thurston Jr. Max Tien. Abigail Tonkinson. Lauren Rose Torla. Megan Torla. Jack Henry Tuziant. Dylan James Trafford. Megan Trong. Charlie Youthganon. Joelle Valentin. Haley Marie Velez. Zachary Ayan Veshi Williams. Marcel Angel Vicente. Alexander Vitsky. Yaffa Warren. Marika Wanda Weber. John Azamat Westfall. Isaiah Williams. Todd Javon Wilson. Spencer Wimpy. Eli Wiesevich. Larry Saroy Womack Jr. Anna Elizabeth Wood. Owen Barry Wood. Emma Cantor Wright. Levi Yellen. Juan Pablo Yepes. Christina Yet. Molly Ann Yeza. Dominic Zaleski. Alexander Nicholas Zayez. John Zare.
Officially graduate the Conard High School class of 2020. But before doing so, I would like to review our end of ceremony procedure. Once instructed to do so,
Each graduate will exit their vehicle from the passenger side and go stand in front of their congratulatory lawn sign. I will then instruct you to turn your tassel from right to left and officially present the class of 2020. We ask that you please do not throw your cap into the air as it compromises our social distancing efforts. Once you have moved your tassel to the left, please remove your lawn sign and bring it into your car with you to proudly display at home. I would encourage everyone to roll down their window to ensure that our graduates can hear my instructions. At this time, would the graduates of the class of 2020 please exit their vehicle from the passenger side? Please move your tassel from right to left. Mr. Moore, West Hartford Board of Education members, and Conard High School faculty and staff, having met the requirements set forth by the West Hartford Board of Education, I present to you the graduates of Conard High School, class of 2020. Congratulations. This concludes our commencement ceremony. As you exit the polo grounds, please enjoy Sunset, a song written and performed by Jason Bruzon, one of our 2020 graduates. I believe the message is a perfect fit for this evening's milestone. Please follow the directions of the Farmington Police Department as you exit the grounds. We will exit one row at a time when directed, starting with the front row. Again, congratulations to the class of 2020.
What's up, Conard class of 2020? My name is Jason Bruzon, and this song right here is for us, for the graduates who had our senior year kind of taken away, but we're still positive, we're still happy. That's what we're about, yeah. We're sitting there chilling at the sunset, wondering what's next at the sunset. We are finally graduating, can't believe we made it, we made it. How about you sit down and listen to truth? We are no longer some children in school. We all hit home runs like we are Babe Ruth. We all blast off like a rocket with fuel. We do not stop, we just keep going. No, we won't shrink, we just keep growing. Let's all stay happy, have positivity, and let's all forget about COVID. We're sitting and chilling at the sunset, wondering what's next at the sunset. We are finally graduating, can't believe we made it, we made it. Now excuse me if I say something wrong, but I think that high school was not too long. And I can tell that we all feel a bit strange, with us trying to deal with all this change. I've been missing my friends on a daily basis, video chats how I see the faces, skipping some classes in free periods. All the school lunches make me delirious. Maybe it's just that I'm doing too much. All of our sports teams keep coming in clutch, like how we beat Hull with the kick. I cannot lie, that was sick. We're sitting and chilling at the sunset, wondering what's next at the sunset. We are finally graduating, can't believe we made it, we made it.
Hi, I'm Keisha.
Hi, I'm Jake.
Hi, I'm Nick.
Hi, I'm Matt.
My name is Sophia.
I'm Tucker.
I'm part of the class of 2020.
I'm part of the class of 2020.
I'm part of the class of 2020.
We're sitting and chilling at the sunset, wondering what's next
at the sunset. We are finally graduating. Can't believe we made it. We made it. We're sitting here chilling at the sunset, wondering what's next at the sunset. We are finally graduating. Can't believe we made it.